cases of COVID-19 in the Philippines on the rise again. That's according to Dr. Guido David of Octa Research. He says the COVID-19 positivity rate in Metro Manila rose to 10% this week from last week's 7%. But he says this data might actually be 10 times higher since cases are most likely underreported. The public is now urged to mask up once again to prevent a further surge of COVID cases.
Sa nakikita natin, hindi pa ito todo at mukhang tataas pa ito. Baka pwede pa siyang umabot ng mga 15% positivity rate. Huwag naman sana lumagpas na 20%. Pag lumagpas na 20%, ibig sabihin medyo madami na yung nagkaka-COVID sa area na yun. Kahit hindi mandatory, I would urge yung mga kababayan natin, lalo na yung mga elderly, yung mga may comorbidities, na mag-mask sila in crowded areas, in public places. Hindi lang naman COVID yung gusto nating iwasan, pati yung mga influenza-like illness na sinasabi nila na may mga na-detect din. Kasi respiratory din lahat eh.
Aside from COVID, the health department is also monitoring another respiratory disease, the walking pneumonia, but it asserts there's still no outbreak yet in the country. Well, the World Bank expecting Philippine growth to accelerate next year as inflation is seen falling back to government's 2-4% target range. Andrea Dequinas with the full story.
The World Bank upbeat about the Philippines' growth prospects next year as inflation in the country cools. The multilateral lender sees the Philippine economy growing by an average of 5.8% in 2024, an improvement from its 5.6% forecast for full year 2023.
We expect that growth will be led by private consumption, as inflation expected to be lower and supported by remittances. On the kind of the sectoral side, we expect that services are going to drive growth. For example, the IT BPO industry will remain resilient. We expect also a pickup in tourism.
But Van Duren also cited various risks that could again trigger higher food and energy prices, such as escalating geopolitical tensions, trade restrictions on agricultural products, as well as El Nino and other weather disturbances. He proposed some measures to mitigate these risks.
It's important that the government uses its contagious strategy of using both monetary, meaning central bank policy rates, and non-monetary policy measures to increase supply of imports, lower the tariffs of key commodities, and assure better supply and demand management for food items.
Despite the World Bank's optimism, its growth forecast for next year is lower than the Philippine government's own target of a 6.5-8% expansion. That's as the World Bank noted, the Philippines is still lagging in terms of attracting investments.
The government has aspirational growth targets. What we recommend the government to do is to put in place both its fiscal policy but also its kind of policy frameworks to try to increase investment. The investment rate of the Philippines is well below that of its neighboring countries, even though it was really ramped up over the last 7 years.
Van Duren also put a premium on the kind of investments that will not only increase the Philippines' capital stock but would also lead to greater productivity. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
More persons of interest in Sunday's deadly bombing in Marawi City. Philippine authorities say they are looking at two more suspects who possibly acted as lookouts. Dennis Dato reports.
Armed forces of the Philippines and the Philippine National Police announced two more potential persons of interest in the Mindanao State University bombing. The two supposedly acted as lookouts for the bomb attack.
Maliban po dito sa POI natin, may dalawa po tayong tinitignan na individual na posibleng nag-lookout, naging nag-serve as lookout po dito. Prior to the explosion po ay nakita po nila itong mga dalawang kalalakihan po na nandun mismo sa loob ng gym. Namukhaan po nila dahil medyo yung interval po ng yung time po na nandun po sila sa loob ay medyo matagal-tagal, kaya napagmasdan po sila nung ilan sa mga witnesses.
AFP spokesperson Colonel Medel Aguilar said they are looking into the possibility of a failure of intelligence on the part of the military in preventing the bomb attack. A BARMM official earlier reported that text messages warning that there would be an attack circulated the night before the incident.
Sa pagkalat po ng sinasabing text messages, ito po ay, I'm sure this will be covered by the investigation that is being conducted now. So we just wait for the result or the conclusion of this investigation for us to answer the succeeding question na kung mayroon bang failure of intelligence or not.
The Philippine National Police, for its part, denied receiving any information related to the attack.
Bago po nangyari ito, ay wala naman pong na-receive ang probar ng any information that would lead to the specifics nitong mga alleged na magkakaroon ng pagbobomba sa Mindanao, particularly doon sa MSUs. At yung ating validation lang naman po ay hindi lang naman po yan limited sa PNP.
A source told ABS-CBN News the bomb was placed inside a black bag. Authorities recovered the damaged bag and metal fragments of the improvised explosive device, which was made from a 60mm mortar and RPG. The bomb was placed in the middle of the gymnasium where the mass was being held. The explosion created a 6x17-inch hole in the gymnasium floor. The PNP said that based on the recovered fragments, the bomb might be linked to a local terrorist group. The forensic team of the NBI Counterterrorism Division is also conducting a post-blast investigation. The Mindanao State University has released the names of the four fatalities: faculty member Evangeline Aromin, students Janine Arenas and Junrey Barbante from the College of Business Administration and Accountancy, and the resident Risa Daniel.
We are devastated, no? But, you know, kung terror groups ang kalaban, we don't give them the success that they want. They want to devastate us, damage us, or break us, pero we are not broken. We will not give them the victory that they want.
Dennis Datu, ABS-CBN News, Marawi City.
The Bangsamoro Region's Interior Minister suspects the bombing in Marawi was aimed at sowing division in the city. Naguib Sinarimbo also underscores the need to rehabilitate Marawi to ensure peace in the area. Marawi City was reduced to rubble during a five-month war against Islamic State-inspired local terrorists back in 2017. Thousands of families remain displaced to this day.
Very deliberate yung attack. One, it targeted a religious gathering by a minority religion inside a majority, Muslim majority community. Yung message is clear. One, they wanted to strike terror. They wanted to divide yung people in Mindanao and in the Bangsamoro between Christians and Muslims. The rehabilitation of Marawi is essential to sustain yung victory in 2017 that we've declared. And if this one gets delayed, the people who laid siege on Marawi in 27 will have reason to say, you look, government does not care about you. All along, we've been correct in saying that we need to fight this government because this government does not care about Muslims.
Road tragedy in Antique, at least 17 are dead after a Ceres bus plunged into a ravine in the town of Hamtik Tuesday afternoon. 12 other passengers survived. The bus came from Iloilo and was en route to Kulasi in Antique when the bus veered off the road. It remains unclear why this happened. Authorities say the area is accident-prone. Vallacar Transit, which owns the ill-fated bus, vows to cooperate with the investigation and extend aid to the victims. The Land Transportation Office also vows to conduct a thorough probe to prevent similar road accidents from happening.